Are you looking for a better way to run music and sound effects from your iPad for your next live show? Well, I've got just the app for you coming up. If you're familiar with live show production, then you're probably familiar with QLab. If you're not, then you're missing out. QLab is a Mac OS X software suite that can run audio and video effects in a live show performance and is used in major concert halls and large installations, including a lot of Broadway theater. Figure 53 makes QLab, and Figure 53 also makes the app that we're talking about today, GoButton. GoButton is the mobile sound cue playback app for iOS that puts the professional sound playback system like QLab right in your pocket. It's available for iPad, iPhone, and iPod Touch. The best part about GoButton is that for your first show, or any one show that you're running at a single time, it's absolutely free for all of the features. So you can try it as long as you want, do as much as you want, and you only have to pay if you're interested in doing multiple shows or setting up multiple scenes, things like that, for multiple days or different events that you're doing. Even if you're doing multiple events, it's a great bargain because the cost for GoButton is only $99, and that covers a single purchase. It's not a yearly subscription or a monthly subscription, and that covers all of your devices, any iPad, iPod, or iPhone that you'll be using this with. Now I want to show you a quick demo of how I've been using GoButton for the past week in a live drama production. The way that GoButton works is that you line up all of your cues in a list exactly how you want them to play, and you even have control of how they start, how they finish, what happens when you play this one, if it cuts off the other one, and then you've also got hits at the bottom, which are instantaneous sound effects. So for instance, and you can stop it as well manually. So I'm going to add a cue here to the end of my list. So now all of these in the documents folder are really easy to get to. So there's two ways to do it that I've used this week. One is you can drop it into iCloud Drive and import it, but I found the easiest thing to do is if you just airdrop a music file to your iPad or iPhone from a Mac where you've got all your sounds downloaded, or if you download them for iTunes, they will also show up in here. But let's say for instance, I want to add in, I'm gonna add in this ladies and gentlemen voiceover. This is actually a stock sound that came with the app when I installed it. So for this ladies and gentlemen voiceover, here's a preview of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages.
So that's a little voiceover that came with the app. And I can even decide, okay, I don't really like that name. It doesn't exactly tell me what it's for or what the sound is. So I can change that and say, ladies and gentlemen and children. And let's say I want to add voiceover in its entirety. I can type in and manually override what that cue is called. It doesn't modify the original MP3 or the file in iTunes, but it does give me an idea in GoButton what I'm actually going to be playing. Now I want to give a quick example of how you can actually modify how some of these cues work and see how that works out. So what I've got is I've got my voiceover set up.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I've got that set up for a duck for the other cues and hits and reduce the volume by 90%. So now I've also got loaded in a curtain call, which is just like a little instrumental band thing that also came with the GoButton app. So I'm gonna play curtain call, and notice when I play the voiceover that the curtain call track drops drastically. But when the voiceover's over, that curtain call track will also go right back up to where it was.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages.
Now that curtain call track comes back up to full volume. So those are just a few examples of some of the easy ways to make running your show much easier. Let me know what you think, and if you have any questions about the GoButton app, this is a very limited scope of what this app is capable of. Within all of the preferences over here, you've got all sorts of cue templates, remote control options, and you've even got easy user manual, support contacts, a forum, and you can also follow GoButton on Twitter for updates and things like that. Let me know what you think, leave a comment below, and like this video if this was helpful information. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm going to be bringing you a lot more tech tips coming up.